everyone, welcome to Loverable. How are you all doing? I hope you all doing pretty well today. And I am on my way to town again. I'm dropping off the Everest for the VW Caravelle, which I'm super excited for. I like that car. And it's a very sad day because the Everest must go. And as you guys know, gross. Oh, what's coming up here? As you guys know, I am a huge fan of this car. I love the Everest. Just the sheer ability that this car has to go absolutely anywhere. And then there's this 10-speed gearbox. But yeah, that's enough about the Everest. I've been literally ranting about this car to everyone I come in contact with. This is the Caravelle, so it's a 4Motion. And look how this thing looks. The doors is electric, so if I push the button, check it. How awesome is that? I can't even begin to explain to you how cool this thing is. Oh my word. This thing is so cool. Yeah, this thing, it's like cool. It's like freezing air wherever I drive. Holy crap. This car is so, this van is so cool. And look at it, man. Holy crap. Yesterday was amazing. I had quite a substantial headache, but everything is fine. I'm on my way now to drive a dream car. But yeah, let's quickly talk about the 530 MLE. So yesterday at BMW, I got to see a Trip 3, as you can probably see now. I got to see a 745i, very limited. And I got to see the 530 MLE, which is a legend in its own, because that car won so many races here in Cape Town, in South Africa. And you know what's even so weird about this? The BMW M division started in South Africa. It started here, and not like per se, but the 530 MLE had the sachet number was 530M. So that's super awesome to think that in those days, 1960s and the 70s, BMWSA was doing such things. They even dropped the M5 motor into the 745 because South Africa didn't offer the turbocharged version. And then they went to go race the 7 Series and won with the 7 Series. But that's a monumental occasion for BMWSA, so congratulations, guys. But yeah, I'm so excited. I can't believe I'm going to do this. I'm just going to get you over there and we'll talk to the owner, right? No, I'm not going to do that transition. Let's just do a pool transition. So let's look who I'm with.
What's up, people?
Mr. Matthew from Good Luck.
What's up, man? How are you?
Right, and you. Good. Finally, I'm meeting you.
I know. When you arrived, we were just speaking for like the entire time before off camera, you know?
Anyway, we're going to check out some of Matthew's cars.
Yeah.
This is a bit of a dream come true for me because I always wanted to drive one of these.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, we can obviously not all of them, so they're all like scattered because.
Yeah, no. We can drive a few. Yeah, whichever one.
Yeah, definitely. I haven't driven this in a long time or so.
Is this yours as well?
Yeah, this is mine. This is probably my collector's, which I'll never probably ever sell. And I did the Rob Green version, like upgrade to it, which is quite cool.
Oh, nice. Is this a proper M?
M Coupe, man. I drove this up to Rob Green, played my show, and literally drove down back home for my show again. And it has now, I think it has like 200 and 80 kilos or something like
that. Yo, but it's the S54, no?
Yeah, is that
engine, yeah, engine, yeah. Engine.
That's why I started watching your videos. You were educating me when it comes to cars. I was like, now I know what motor that is, you know?
Holy.
Yeah, so this only has 50,000 Ks on it.
Yo! Look at this interior, bruh.
Pretty much there's nothing on it, which, but I'll never sell this car, which is...
I can imagine.
It's probably a bit dirty.
Oh my god.
I need to clean it. I haven't
Dude!
I haven't been home long enough to clean it, so...
Throttles!
Dude, man. I'm not gonna lie, this is probably one of my...
Oh, shit.
Oops.
Yeah.
This is probably one of my, I think, the best cars I've ever, like, driven. Just from a purest car, you know?
We need to go in this one.
No, we can
go,
of course. We can drive this.
Oh.
I still can't believe you haven't driven a
E46. I've never driven as much as I love an S54 engine, is as much as I want to drive one.
Yeah. It's just like all you do is like traction on off, although I don't touch that button. I did have a problem with this once before. And I drove for like 4 months without traction control on. And man,
how's it in the wet?
Oh, it's not, you don't want to press that button. I would just do this. Like this, and then it will just go.
The back will come out.
Yeah, I'm like, yeah, see. That's, so it wasn't like really safe, you know? But I mean, it's still fun.
It is fun. I was in the M2 a few weeks back and I was like doing slides everywhere.
And that thing just spins all the
easy
time.
Easy peasy. Easy peasy.
I'll play the fourth one.
Yeah. I tried to mount the mic in a way that you can hear. I'm so shocked. I've been a Lotus 7. It's like a fucking dream come true, bruh.
Yeah,
I like such cars, man. It's always been a thing.
Probably have to put in fuel soon.
Yeah.
So have you ever done one before?
No, never. Never, ever.
Yo, that's cool, man. I'm excited. The only difference is the first gear is so close to reverse.
Oh!
It's like super close.
Yeah! No, that sound!
That sound, man.
Going in a drive-thru in a Lotus 7.
McDonald's, man. This is a proper meal, bro. Never done this before, actually.
Never. A stone like flipped across here now.
You gotta... Give them the welcome horn.
We have a medium Cajun meal, please. Hungry?
Actually, I'm gonna cheat. A Fanta orange, please.
And no, please.
Can I get a Big Mac medium meal? No cheese. Okay. And a Coke Light.
Okay. Coke light, please.
No, it's fine, we're gonna park an hour somewhere.
Oh shit.
Whoa! No, it's cool. And to be nice and short.
Oh yeah, exactly. Mm. And this box is pretty strong, man.
Mm. Clutch. Yo, it's stiff. It's throttle pedal.
Oh, the throttle?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you have quite broad feet now.
Broad shoes.
Seriously, yeah, it's probably not the best.
Yeah, these not the best at all. Yo, how do you drive this thing? I see what you say about the first gear.
Yeah, it's so close. That's reverse. That's reverse. That's reverse. That's first.
Yeah. You used to this car already.
It takes a little getting used to, but. Because obviously there's no assist, right?
Yeah, there's indicators here.
Yeah, they're the one. You just flick to the, this, I guess, the left.
Oh!
And then middle.
Oh, okay, quiet. Guys, it takes getting used to, trust me. Yeah, dude. I can't believe I'm behind the wheel of a Lotus 7. I'm like shook.
And thank goodness we're like the same height because this doesn't adjust.
Yes, you know? We are the same height.
So it doesn't really be, the seat is like fixed to the
At least I didn't stall it yet. Yo, bruh, what a car! Tracking because of the road. I hope you guys can hear me, but you should feel the steering wheel. It's like I'm turning the wheel with my actual hands. So much feel is coming through here. Like I can feel everything.
Yeah, everything coming through.
Yeah.
And like, I mean, you can do this and you'll feel it's like, you know, super direct.
Yo, it's amazing. Yo, dude, I'm the dream come through. I can't believe I'm doing this. Make sure I'm in the right gears.
You can feel it now, but you feel the handling.
Yeah. I'm not in the balls.
Go,
back to the studio. Yeah, we'll do some. We'll try and get him to a pool weekly in a nice quiet road. Maybe some of by your.
Oh yeah, we can do it. Yeah. That's
I think I was in third gear.
It's hard to find first gear.
It is. It's tricky.
It's so close. I don't know why it's like that.
Especially if you're not used to it.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm. Who'd you in the car if I may ask?
It's Gerard, his name's Gerard.
From GSR.
GSR.
Yeah.
You know everyone.
Yeah. Let's go. How much kilowatt does this car make?
Maybe about just probably on 200.
Yes.
So I know we want to put more into it.
Yeah.
But to be honest, I don't mind it as is.
Yeah. My brother's car with the same engine, 3S GTE.
Yeah.
It's making 242.
Gee whiz, yeah. That's insane. Now, maybe that, a couple more kilos like that,
yeah,
would be actually very nice.
Yeah.
A lot smoother than another one.
Yeah. Guys, so again, the wind noise is probably going to be intense. But, yeah. this is different.
Yeah, it's a complete different.
But it drives lekker.
Like
over here, it drives smooth.
Also, there's no windscreen though.
Yeah. But this is already feeling stupid fast compared to the other one.
I know.
You didn't even put your foot down yet.
Yeah, I think this one, I mean, this one outperforms the other one, obviously, performance wise.
Yeah.
Insane. But on the mountain pass, I mean, they. Obviously, you need the speed to come out.
Yeah.
Mic'd up.
Yeah,
We're probably gonna have a bit of
oh, that's it, yeah.
I'm probably gonna talk a lot louder than I usually do. But yeah, so is where's the handbrake
here? Oh yeah, the handbrake down there.
Oh. Oh yeah, this drive is very easy.
Easy, eh?
Yeah, no, this is so easy peasy. Right, Matthew, so
yo,
why do you like this thing?
Well, I mean, I think firstly, the Lotus is naturally aspirated. This one's obviously turbocharged, but
yeah,
I just love how, I mean, it's so grounded, this car, eh?
Yeah.
Especially on the mountain turns and stuff. It's a really a fun car to drive.
And the brakes actually is just as nice as the other car because it's so light.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, so he's gonna struggle to hear me. How are we talking? And I'm gonna struggle.
I can't read your lips.
Yeah. That's hilarious.
But I mean, it's a complete different. I think it's more the Lotus slightly more tail happy and
yes,
stuff.
Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, this is a monster.
Yeah, this one's a level up of that car now.
Yeah.
Speed wise, I think overall everything speed wise.
It's gears now, guys. I must get used to. The gears is not the easiest.
Yeah, I struggle also myself.
Yeah. Yeah, but it's okay once you get going. And it's because it's so light.
I know, this one weighs 830 kilos, I think.
Yo! Sorry, so my mask keeps fogging up because of my nose.
I mean,
so I lift it up a little.
Yeah, and then obviously it's the motor out of the MR2.
Mm-hmm.
You said it was 3S GTE.
Yes, 3S GTE.
Yeah, there we go.
Did he say Gen 2?
Gen 3.
Gen 3, okay. So this one's got a stronger bottom end than the other 3S GTEs. This can handle a bit more boost.
A little rain.
Whoa! Where's this coming from? We didn't order any rain today.
I know, we never.
Shit!
Your camera gear is fine, right?
Okay. Yeah, cover up.
I'll just cover with the cap.
We're gonna drive out of it now.
Yeah. We'll get a good rinse out of this.
Yeah.
Now. I think it's only here though.
Yes, I think so too. Guys, so this is so interesting. This is one of Matthew's businesses. And it's a Mo.
It's called Mobi Wash. So basically, it's an Uber equivalent for car washing. So, I mean, we always know when you go for your car wash, and then you always see, yes, it's full, can I get a car wash? So basically, it's to create convenience. Literally, it's on the app stores, Google.
I'll put it in the description box for you guys in the dialogue.
Yeah, definitely.
And this place looks sharp.
This is actually just where we store our cars now. We have premises and pumps and stuff, but the whole convenience is just booking a car wash and we'll come to you. Book the times, wherever it gives you the time slots, everything. Yeah, you can just check it out.
Awesome. Cool. Check it out. The description box below.
Yeah. I still can't believe that it's the first time driving this engine, man. You've driven pretty much every single car you can imagine.
I still can't believe you're making me drive this car because I'm going to fall in love. No, what are you doing to me? And I actually wanted a 63. I was telling you, man. A Smarka C63.
Yeah, man. That's a tail happy car, that one there.
Yeah.
No.
What a liquor car.
I love it.
Actually, that car isn't very tail happy in a straight line, believe it or not.
Is it?
You can clap that car from the line, it'll go straight.
But if you want it to come out.
If you want it, you can agitate it because it's an open diff. But obviously a 507, the one of the LSDs, are a bit more trickier to handle out of the hole.
And I suppose that's a lot of fun. It comes with a lot of fun though.
It is a lot of fun, to be honest with you. It's a hell of a lot of fun. Okay, I'm gonna take it easy first because I don't know the car. Just get used to the clutch and stuff.
Yeah, it's the first time.
Yeah. Yeah. Naturally aspirated, bruh. You can't beat this engine.
No, you can't, man.
So, at Saldana, a car with this engine, turbocharged, won all the 2JCs and stuff like that on the day.
No, you're kidding me.
Seriously.
This engine?
These engines make beastly power turbocharged, but they're expensive to make go fast.
Okay.
But I don't know, man, I prefer the naturally aspirated, especially with the, if you fit maybe the, it's so light on the throttle.
It is, eh?
Oh, dude, it's not a slow car, no? I wasn't even revving it.
Yeah, no, that was,
yeah, it's like
fire. You put a sports button on.
Like I said, the power's like,
yeah.
So this one's up at now, I would say around close to 280 with 280 kilowatts. I must figure out the newton meters. I can't remember when what it was then. But I remember I drove it up to Rob Green. He did all his things, and I just drove it back down. And each time we come, obviously to sea level, it's just you can feel it getting a lot more responsive.
If you a boosted car, doesn't feel above altitude as much as a naturally aspirated car, because it obviously feeds off the what you call it, the atmospheric pressure.
Yeah.
But this car, the only thing that's a bit dodgy with this car for me is the suspension's a bit.
It is, eh?
Yeah.
It's quite hard.
Yeah, it's jiggly. But it's not a problem. I'm sure on the track this thing is a weapon.
It is. The thing with the Z4 though on the track is the nose is slightly, since it's like a long nose, right? It tends to understeer slightly sometimes.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, interesting. Okay, but and you obviously got it to that point.
Yeah, I mean it's you can feel it. So you just gotta be a bit, I don't know, you just gotta balance it out a little.
Yeah.
And then you know, rather throw the back out, then it's easier.
Yeah. And this car's got only 56,000 kilometers on the clock.
Yeah, pretty much. I hardly drive it. I think the last time in a year I drove 1,000 km, I think.
I can imagine. These S54s require quite a bit of maintenance.
Yeah, and if you don't drive it, they start to pack up. So
yes.
I didn't drive it and the starter messed up and I had to buy a new starter.
Actually, S54s have common bearing issues.
Really?
Not the clutch. I'm just the clutch. But what happens is with them, the guys don't throw the right oil in, or they drive the cars hard when it's cold.
Oh yes, I see.
But I know some people with 200, 220,000 on the clock, still stock bottom end, stock top end, just proper maintenance.
Just proper maintenance.
The cutter oil service is way shorter than what they're supposed to.
I think that's actually the key to maintain it, right?
Exactly. Yeah, no. You know what's so weird is like how this motor revs and outputs power down.
Yeah, especially with the traction.
Yeah.
It's not a fancy traction control. It's literally off and on. It's not even the ones that are old.
Yeah.
And it manages to put the power
on. Left or right?
Side or right? Right, yeah. Okay. Oh, you're going left. Yeah. Sorry. My bad. We're not going there anymore.
Then right here.
No? Right here, yes. By the way.
This bus.
Man, I'm falling in love with this car. And,
cool as... But
man, the stuff you can do inside here. Just from a holiday perspective. Ooh, you know?
Matthew.
Man, thank you so much, bro.
I appreciate it so much. Guys, check him out. Check out Good Luck.
Yeah. Cool, buddy. We'll see you guys soon.
And so does this video draw to a close. I just want to thank all of you so much for supporting me. And last week's video did almost over 13,000 views. And I kind of came out about being kind of depressed and stuff. And I just want to thank all of you for understanding and bearing with me. I really appreciate it. It's not easy. I think like having to, like, you know, being a dude and in Cape Town and stuff, like people kind of judge you when you say stuff like that. But I'm just so happy that all the amount of messages that popped up, like of people saying thank you, the amount of people going through the same thing that I'm going through was phenomenal. I'm so happy I can help all of you. And I'm not going to stop talking about what I'm going through because it can help so much of you. And in Cape Town, that's what all of us need right now, is to help each other out, to be there for one another and to not break each other down, especially in the car community, where if you don't have don't mean to speak down on people with GTIs and stuff, but like a GTI or an M3 or an Audi RS3 or a TTRS or a GTR or any high performance car, kids nowadays go like, I want to be like that, you know. And they mentally beat themselves down because financially they can't put themselves there. So I just want to tell all those people who think they can't do it and who can't drive a cool car and who can't do what they want to do, just keep pushing, guys. Just keep pushing. Don't give up, because trust me, I was literally in the dark zone last year and beginning of this year, where I was like, you know what, all this hard work and like it's not even benefiting my life in a financial way, but I think at the end of the day it will come and it will happen and it will make you successful if you just believe in and you keep doing what you believe in. People always look at me like I'm a mad thing when I'm talking to myself here on the phone, but yeah, I'm actually gonna get something to eat now. Thank you so much, Matthew, for letting me drive a few of your cars. I really appreciate it. And I am loving the vlogs. I'm loving the creation behind it. It took me about 3 days to edit this video, to be honest with you. So yeah, it is a bit long. Those of you who made it this far, please comment in the comment box below if you made it this far. Like, say I made it this far, or hashtag made it far. Just do the hashtag for me. And I know you guys watched the video finished. But anyway, guys, I'm not going to keep you here forever. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up button, subscribe, share with friends and family. Be free, be you. Be rebel. Out.